Welcome, Japanese woodblock print collectors and enthusiasts. I just finished binge-watching an animated series on Netflix called Blue Eye Samurai. This series draws on Japanese history, culture, and art, including woodblock prints. In this video, I'll discuss some of the influences that are related to this animated series. First, a quick synopsis. The show creators, Michael Green and Amber Noizumi, described the show as an Edo period tale of revenge, Kill Bill meets Yentl. The series is set in 1650s Japan. The protagonist, Mizu, is a half-white, half-Japanese female samurai. The show is not for the faint of heart because there's a lot of action with blood gushing and limbs flying. All this is delivered in really amazing cinematic style, inspired by films like Akira Kurosawa movies, the Zatoichi series, Kill Bill, Lady Snowblood, and many others. It boasts first-class voiceover talent. Maya Erskine, George Takei, Kenneth Branagh, Masi Oka, Randall Park, Brenda Song, and many others. Blue Eye Samurai is not based on a true story, but there are some historical parallels. The first being that a real Blue Eye Samurai did come to Japan in the 1600s. His name was William Adams, an English navigator who was forced to stay in Japan. He helped the shogun Tokugawa Ieyasu build Japan's first Western-style ships. He was held in high regard by the Japanese people, samurai, and the ruling classes until his death in 1620. It's interesting to compare the European image of him with the Japanese one. Another important historical reference is that women could become samurai in Japan. Onna musha is a term referring to female warriors. These women fought in battle alongside samurai men. They were trained in the use of weapons to protect their household, family, and honor in times of war. Don't confuse these women with the female bandits or onna datte that were also depicted in stories, plays, and prints. Probably the most famous female samurai in Japanese history was Tomoe Gozen, or Lady Gozen. Many woodblock print artists depicted her, and here are some examples. Tomoe Gozen lived during the late 12th century. She was known for her skill in archery and sword fighting. The Tale of Heiki, which is a chronicle of the Genpei War, describes her as especially beautiful, with white skin, long hair, and charming features. She was also a remarkably strong archer, and as a swordswoman, she was a warrior worth a thousand, ready to confront a demon or a god, mounted or on foot. Another famous female warrior was Han Gaku Gozen. She is said to have been fearless as a man and beautiful as a flower, and to have wielded a naginata in battle. The naginata is a long pole arm weapon that is preferred by female warriors. She fought unsuccessfully against the Kamakura shogunate and was sent off to be executed, but she was spared by a warrior who then married her. One of the last samurai in history was Nakano Takeko. She was a Japanese warrior who fought and died during the Battle of Aizu. She also fought with a naginata and was the leader of a group of women warriors. During the battle, the imperial troops realized that their enemies were female warriors and their commanders ordered the troops not to kill them. That was a big mistake, because this gave Nakano's warriors the chance to attack. Nakano herself killed 5 or 6 soldiers with her naginata before being shot in the chest. Rather than letting the enemy cut off her head as a war trophy, Nakano asked her sister Yuko to behead her in order to prevent her capture, as well as give her an honorable burial. Switching to the topic of fashion, I want to note the jingasa hat that Mizu is wearing. The word jingasa is made up of two symbols, kasa meaning hat and jin meaning military. Also, her glasses that are tinted yellow to hide her blue eyes resemble one of the world's oldest surviving pair of glasses from 15th century Japan. The background scenery in Blue Eye Samurai is gorgeously rendered. The production designer Jason Shear drew inspiration from Hiroshi Yoshida's woodblock prints. Here we can see some examples of the background art and Yoshida's prints. If you are interested in female warriors, samurai, or just a great animated story, I strongly recommend you check out the first season of Blue Eye Samurai on Netflix. Until next time, please like and subscribe, and happy collecting.